Welcome to our channel Life Insights. This time our question is, why sex is a very serious problem with us? Why do we discuss this problem here? Because it is directly related with spiritual life. Without going beyond sex, there would be no spiritual life at all. So it is our responsibility to understand about this energy. We are born through this creative energy. Therefore, it cannot be against us. It is a part of us because we are born through it. So we must understand it. Now, why is sex a serious problem with us? It is because of our own mind and thinking. Mind makes everything as problematic. The job we are involved in, the place we are living in, whatever we touch, the mind turns those things as problematic. It is the characteristic of the mind. So before understanding sex, we have to understand our own mind. Our mind creates this problem. Life itself is a problem. We often say, many people say, that life itself is a problem. But life is not at all a problem. Life is a natural phenomenon. Since we are faced with so many conflicts, we consider that life is a battlefield. We don't know the art of living. That's why we say that life is problematic. So, it is better to understand the sexual energy. Society is encouraging sex through various advertisements in the front pages of the magazines we see. All the cinemas are encouraging this. Simultaneously, the society considers sex as a taboo. So, an individual is caught between the two extremes. He can neither suppress nor express. Then what to do? Therefore, an individual inwardly feels guilty for sexual activity is considered as a taboo. Without understanding the sexual energy, we try to fight with it. Fighting strengthens the self. Thus, the problem cannot be tackled. We find that many people are practicing brahmacharya. Brahmacharya cannot be practiced. We consider that there is a stage beyond the sex. Spirituality aims at arriving at that place where there is no sexual content. Therefore, it becomes a very important aspect as far as spiritual aspirant is concerned. Thought creates everything as problematic. If sex is a problem, then taking food is also a problem. Eating, drinking, walking, everything becomes a problem to us. So, before understanding sex, we have to understand our day-to-day activities in the life. We have to be aware about all the activities of our life. For that, a meditative mind is needed. A meditative mind is interested in creativity. In the sexual act, the self is absent. Therefore, it gives lots of pleasure. So the mind wants again and again such activity. But we feel repelled by other activities of life. Going to the office, working in the field, we feel very bored. So we must be aware about all the other activities because we have only one energy with us. We can't divide this as sexual and another activity as non-sexual. we have got only one creative energy. We must be aware of that energy. When we become sexual, we are the sex. So there is no difference between sex and us. It is a part of us. When this duality disappears, then the problem will be resolved. We assume that our brain has the capacity to go beyond sex. If we understand our thought process, it is entirely possible. Thinking about sex creates lots of problems. The act in itself is not problematic. When we involve ourselves in sexual activity, we don't bother about it. We enjoy it. But since the sex actual act is over, we feel very guilty. So it is a trick of the mind. Thoughts create this kind of duality. Once we understand the thought process, we will be able to go beyond sex very easily. That is the purpose of a spiritual aspirant. It looks very difficult, but if we observe our own thoughts, it is possible here and now. Once again, we will be coming up with another one video explaining another one aspect of life.